Hello, welcome to GYAS. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel, we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services. And for that purpose, we have started MCQ series of different topics like Ancient India, Medieval India, Modern India, Polity, Geography, etc. So what we are doing in these series, basically, we daily cover 5 questions of each topic and we will continue to do so till 31st May. So for example, we are covering today lecture number 4 of Indian Polity. And we will cover the 5 questions of in this lecture. In this manner, we will continue to do so till 31st May. So if you go by calculation, then approximately 1000 questions of each topic will be covered. So why the date chosen has been 31st May? Because on 2nd June is your prelims of UPSC Civil Services and we will end this series only one day before your exam. So you can imagine that if you are practicing 1000 questions of each topic, then how much practice you will be doing before your prelims exam. That is much needed for getting a great margin and edge over other students in the exam hall. So this series, if you follow these series daily, then you will feel confident slowly as the progress takes place. So we are on the lecture number 4 of Indian Polity. Already we have covered lecture, for example, of environment, we have covered lecture 46 lectures. So of Ancient India, we have covered 18 lectures. So in certain series, we have covered a lot of lectures, but the Polity and Geography series has been recently started by us. So that's why we have not covered much lectures of them. So do follow these series regularly if you want to be confident in your prelims exam. So let's start our discussion. The first question is, consider the following about the role of International Court of Justice. First is, only states are eligible to appear before the court. No private entity can move the International Court of Justice. Second is, it provides individuals and groups with legal counseling and helps them deal with the authorities of any state in major human rights violations. Third is, it is the final appellate court for decisions passed by major international tribunals. So friends, let me tell you that only statement that is correct is the first statement, that is only the states, that nation states are eligible to appear before the court and no other private entity can move to the international court justice, whatever be the case may be. So regarding the second statement, it is not mandated to provide, it is prohibited to provide legal counseling to individuals and groups, so in dealing with their authorities of any state. So in case of major human rights violation. Third statement is also incorrect because it is not final appellate court, because nation states are sovereign in themselves and the courts of these nation states are the final, for example, of India, there is a Supreme Court. That is the final appellate court, and there is no appellate court above Supreme Court where the appeal of the Indian nationals could lie. So in that manner, it doesn't act as final appellate court. So third statement is also correct. So the only option correct is, only statement correct is first. So the correct answer is A. Now that is one only. So the solution is A. So here is the explanation. So it has no jurisdiction to deal with the applications from individuals, non-governmental organizations, corporations, or any other private entity. So only states are eligible. Also, it is not a supreme court to which national courts can turn. It does not act as a court of last resort for individuals. So however, there is also further explanation about which you can see in the explanation PDFs, which I will provide to you in the end. So you can see there are other additions to this. So let's move on to the second question. The second question is, which of the following are the fundamental rights provided by the Constitution of India? First is, no person shall be deprived of his property save by the authority of law. Second is, all linguistic and religious minorities shall have the right to establish and administer educational institutions of their choice. So we have to choose which of the following is the fundamental rights. So let me tell you friends that the fundamental right, first statement is incorrect, that it is not a fundamental right. The right to property is not a fundamental right. Why it is so? Because friends, it used to be the fundamental right, but after independence, it was removed from the list of fundamental rights by the 44th amendment, and it was made only a constitutional or legal right. It is now not a fundamental right. Regarding the second, yes, it is correct, that all the linguistic and religious minorities have the right to establish the administer educational institutions of their choice. So this statement is correct. So the correct option is second only, that is B. So solution is B. So this is about the second question. So here we have not provided the explanation of the second question, because friends, we provide the explanation of only first question. If you want the explanation of further questions, then you will have to subscribe to our initiative of these daily MCQs. We are putting in lot of energy. So if you want to get the explanation of every question, then you need to subscribe to the explanation PDFs. So we only provide the explanation of first question so that you might have idea that what type of explanation we provide and whether it is up to the level of UPSC or not, or whether you need to have the explanation PDFs or not. So by seeing the first question, you will be able to understand that whether we need it or not. So the third question is, which of the following terms have not been defined in the Constitution? So here we have been asked which of the following is not defined. A option is defined. A option is union territories, B is security, C is agricultural income, D is procedure established by law. So friends, let me tell you that union territory is also explained in your Constitution. Security, like stock market, all these things are explained, and agricultural income is also explained, but the procedure established by law has not been defined in your Constitution. So the correct option is D, that is procedure established by law has no definition in our Constitution. So this is the solution is so D. So let's move on to your fourth question. The fourth question is the term of Rajya Sabha. For A option is can be extended by an extraordinary presidential order, B is can be extended by 6 months at a time by ordinary legislation, C is can be extended by 1 year at a time during proclamation of emergency, D is none of the above. So friends, let me tell you that Rajya Sabha is a permanent body, that is, it is not subject to dissolution like the case with Lok Sabha. So we cannot dissolve the Rajya Sabha, it remains there for permanence. So when it is a permanent body, it is not going anywhere, then there is no question of extending its term. So answer is D, that is none of the above. So this is the correct answer. If you want the further explanation, then it is available in the explanation PDFs. So fifth question is, as per the present arrangements, appointments committee of the cabinet includes. So you know friends, there is an appointment committee which decides on the important offices that is to be given to different individuals the important offices of Indian government that are to be given to Indian individuals. So that this committee decides those appointments. So the task of allotting different posts to different individuals of important posts. The appointments to important posts is decided by with this appointments committee. So it includes A is Prime Minister and Minister of Home Affairs only. B is Prime Minister, Minister of Home Affairs, Minister of Finance, Minister of External Affairs and Minister of Defence only. C is Prime Minister, Minister of Home Affairs, Minister of Finance, Minister of External Affairs, Minister of Urban Development and Minister of Corporate Affairs. D is Prime Minister and all Cabinet Ministers. So let me tell you friends that the correct option is A, that is Prime Minister and Home Minister only. So the appointment committee which decides the appointment to important offices it has two members only, that is the Prime Minister and the Minister of Home Affairs only. So the correct answer is A. So this is all about friends today's lecture. So if you want to get the explanation PDFs, then you can subscribe to them. I will explain the procedure to you now. And friends, lastly, let me tell you that why it is important to subscribe to important PDFs, explanation PDFs, because at the end of the day, friends, you will not be able to see the long videos that are 15 to 20 minute long. And also you will not be able to revise your whole syllabus via bulky books that are standard books like NCERTs and Lakshmikant, because at that time you will not have that much of time to revise them. At the most, you can read standard book two times. After that, they start boring us. So in order to keep our interest high, because it is the only thing that decides your selection, the thing that decides your selection is revision, and revision is done by reading again and again, and reading again and again is not easy task because it becomes boring. So if you want to make your study interesting, then you must follow a format in which your interest remains at a high level. So this question answer format is a time tested tool by which you can revise your whole syllabus in an effective manner, because friends, ultimately UPSC is not just about seeing questions and their answers. UPSC is much more than that. UPSC you see a question and then you see its explanation, and further and you see that why a particular option is correct and why others are not correct. Why, friends, this is important? Because it clears your concept in a comprehensive manner and helps you in revising comprehensively and helps you in clearing your small doubts. So in this way, the revision can happen. So approximately, if we are covering 1,000 questions till 31st May, they will not be 1,000 questions. In fact, they will be 4,000 concepts, because with each question, explanation will be given where a particular option which is correct, it will be told to you that why it is correct, and a particular other options that are not correct will be told to you that why they are incorrect and in which context they will be correct. So in this way, the revision can happen. So if you want to subscribe to these initiatives, you can WhatsApp us at this number, that is 8968-6426481. So we are charging you a very minimum amount for the purpose of our motivation. If you want to subscribe to the PDFs, you can WhatsApp us at this given number, that is 8968-426481. So here is the number. So friends, let me tell you that the cost there, for example, take the example of environment. So we are charging for the explanation PDFs of environment just rupees 50. So it is not 50 rupees for one PDF. It is 50 rupees for entire PDFs that we have covered earlier. And also the forthcoming PDFs that we will cover till 31st May. So you can see that already we have covered 47 lectures, and we will approximately cover 100 to 100 to 130 more lectures in coming days till 31st May. So you can see that how much practice you will be doing by following these series, and you are getting these explanation PDFs in just rupees 50. That is, you have to make a single time payment. There is no repeated payment. And similar is the case with ancient India, medieval India, modern India, geography and polity. So complete package is of 950, but in case if you want to subscribe to any individual series, then it is your choice. So we are offering you people a discount of rupees 150 on this complete package if you want to subscribe to them in a complete form. So the package, for the package, we are offering you a discount, and the complete package is available to you in 800. So you can WhatsApp us at this number if you want to subscribe to them. So this is all about, friends, today's lecture of polity. Thank you, friends. Thank you very much. And do follow our channel, and do not forget to press the bell icon, because then only you will get important notifications of all the important updates that we do on our YouTube channel for the purpose of UPSC CSE 2019. So thank you.